Ed Nemeth, and I'm a pharmacologist by training, and I worked on the discovery and development of drugs that activate or inhibit the calcium receptor. Drugs that activate the calcium receptor I called calcimimetics because they mimic or potentiate the effects of extracellular calcium at the calcium receptor. And drugs that antagonize the calcium receptor are called calcilytics. I played a pivotal role in the discovery and development of both these classes of compounds, and I'm pleased to say that at least one class has become a marketed drug, and that is cinacalcet. It's been approved for the treatment of secondary hyperparathyroidism in patients on dialysis, and also for the treatment of severe forms of primary hyperparathyroidism, or in those patients who refuse or cannot tolerate surgical removal of the parathyroid glands. It's also approved for the treatment of parathyroid carcinoma. So it is a novel, first-in-class drug for the treatment of these forms of hyperparathyroidism. The calcilytic story, the calcium receptor antagonists, does not have quite such a happy ending. They were initially developed for the treatment of osteoporosis. And while they showed promising results in preclinical animal models, they failed to have efficacy in a phase 2 study in postmenopausal women with osteoporosis. Three different companies developed calcilytics for treatment of osteoporosis, and all three of those compounds that entered the clinic have failed to show efficacy. But that doesn't mean that calcilytics as a treatment for other diseases is not possible. In fact, calcilytics are now being repurposed for the treatment of some rare diseases like autosomal dominant hypocalcemia and some not so rare diseases like asthma. We don't know whether or not the calcilytics will prove to be effective in these disorders, but the initial results in humans for ADH are encouraging, and the results that have been obtained in mouse models of asthma do suggest that they may someday play a role in the treatment of asthma and perhaps other inflammatory lung disorders. Thank you.